Hello friends, I welcome you all to AGTAP. So today we have brought for you another very important lecture under your GA series. Today we are going to cover January 10th to 12th, and this particular series is important for RBI Grade B, NABARD Grade A, SEBI Grade A and the assistant examinations of RBI and NABARD both. So here you can see the various courses which are being offered by us. You can choose from any of these courses. We have individual as well as the combo courses. And here you can see about our previous results. We have been working in this field from quite some time now and we have some brilliant results with us. So RBI Grade B of 2017, 27 of our students got selected, and NABARD Grade A of 2018, let me tell you that there were 46 generalist seats, and out of the 46 seats, 26 were taken by EduTapians. And RBI Grade B of 2018, the interviews are going on, and let me tell you that 280 of our students are going through this interview phase. So we are again expecting a brilliant result here. So now coming back to lecture of the day, let us see what is your first news. Okay, so your very first news is about the Khelo India Youth Games. So this is the second edition of Khelo India Games, which is now taking place in Pune, Maharashtra. So you need to remember this place. Pune is important for the second edition of this Khelo India Games. So Khelo India program itself we are going to discuss, but let us first see what is this news about. So under this Khelo India Youth Games, which is the second edition, 5 minutes or campaign has been launched by the Ministry of Youth Affairs. So you can see here our sports minister, Rajyavardhan Rathore. So he has actually launched this 5 minute or campaign to emphasize the children to for the parents to let them play for 5 minutes extra. So that is a kind of campaign. So that extra 5 minutes effort would actually lead to the result. And since this is the second edition, the first edition was actually has taken place in New Delhi, the capital city, and the this is the title you can see here, Kheloge Kudoge Banoge Laag Jawab. So this was the title for the last year, and this time it is this campaign. So let us quickly see about this Khelo India program itself. So it is a national program which has been launched by our Ministry of Youth Affairs and Sports, and basically it is aimed at reviving the sports culture in India. So the sports culture at the grassroots level to be revived, so that talented players can come across. And for this, the players would be provided with the annual financial assistance of rupees 5 lakh per annum. So this is important for you. Keep this in mind that INR 5 lakh per annum would be spent for 8 years. So you can see that if the talented students, children are tapped at the very young age and then they are given training, then finally, obviously, they'll be able to give brilliant results. So this is the actually the 12 prong program of this Khelo India scheme. So you can just go through it, that play field development, then community coaching development, state level Khelo India centers have been organized, and sports for women are there, sports for even peace and development. So these are some very important things. Go through them and do keep in mind about the Khelo India Youth Games in Pune as well as the last one which has taken place in New Delhi. So moving forward to your next news. Okay, so World Hindi Day. January 10th is being celebrated as the World Hindi Day. I will just tell you that actually you don't need to get this Hindi Day confused with National Hindi Divas. So Hindi Divas is actually celebrated on September 14th, but we are talking about the World Hindi Day. So actually on January 10th, 1975 in this year, the first World Hindi Conference was actually inaugurated by then Prime Minister Indira Gandhi. So that had taken place in Nagpur. To commemorate this particular day and to promote the greatness of the Hindi language at the global stage, this day is particularly celebrated. So keep this in mind about January 10th as well as the September 14th. So some important things I've mentioned about Hindi, you can read about them, that the fourth most spoken language in the world, and some grammar which is used in Hindi is actually different because it has actually been also adopted as the official language of the Pacific Island country of Fiji. So some important things, you can just go through them. Apart from that, only January 10th you need to keep in mind. Okay. So this is about the space fuel. So IIT Madras has actually come up with this space fuel. They say that they have developed this space fuel in lab itself. So the interstellar conditions they had simulated in their lab, and finally they came out with this space fuel. So that means the fuel which can be used in space, and they have published this paper according to which the molecules of methane, carbon dioxide, etc., they can be caged and then they can be used as a fuel in the space. So that is a very important innovation, a discovery which has been done by them. So this is important. IIT Madras related to the these cages, the crystalline solids which are called as clathrate hydrates. Do keep this in mind, and IIT Madras also. Okay, so this is about a very important program, Gangajal project. So PM has finally launched this Gangajal project. Actually, this is important because it was actually started in 2005 and had to be completed by 2012. But finally, now in 2019, it has been launched by our Prime Minister. So this, let us see what is this Gangajal project all about. So this project is aimed at providing the city of Taj Mahal, that is Agra, with the better and more assured water supply. So this is about this Gangajal project, and you need to know that the Taj Mahal, the city Agra, is actually on the banks of river Yamuna. So don't get confused it with Ganga. And it is actually aiming at providing the 140 cubic of Ganga water to Agra, so that the drinking water needs of the city can be fulfilled through this particular project. So some other initiatives were also taken at the same launch program, but this Gangajal project is more important, so do keep this in mind. So let us move forward then. Okay, so this is important. Now, India's longest single lane steel cable bridge, that is the suspension bridge, has finally been opened. So so many bridges we are seeing, we have covered in our previous videos also, the single lane, this is the suspension bridge, then there was this longest bridge, largest bridge. So you have to keep all these in mind, and let me just give you a hint that all these are actually the three bridges, including this one, they are actually in the northeast itself. So this becomes important to keep in mind. And this particular, the suspension bridge, the single lane one, is in the state of Arunachal Pradesh. So the bridge is named as the Bayerong Bridge, and it is across the river Siang. So Siang River is important for us, and as per this bridge and the other previous bridge which we have covered, you must be able to recall that they were actually on the river Brahmaputra. So do recall that, and keep this one also in mind. Okay. Now the important news is here, Democracy Index of 2018 has been released. So this actually Democracy Index is released by The Economist. So there is this, The Economist is actually a newspaper, EIU, that is The Economist Intelligence Unit. It releases this Democracy Index, and the rank for India's in this particular index is very important. But let me first tell you that what is this index all about. See, there are five categories based on which this index is formed. So these are, as it is measuring the democracy, so these five pillars are actually important, the five categories rather, based on which the index gives the scoring. So the first one is electoral process and the pluralism. So pluralism is very important in democracy, that is measured here. Then civil liberties, functioning of the government, and political participation, how much people are actually coming to participate in the politics, and finally, the political culture. So these are the five categories based on which this index is made, and on the basis of it, there are four regimes which are laid out, that is full democracy, flawed democracy, hybrid regime, and authoritarian regime. So this was about the background of this Democracy India Index. Now, Democracy Index, not the India one, but now coming back to India's rank in this index. India, being the largest democracy in the world, is placed under the category of the flawed democracy. So no improvement even in this year's index. Last year also India was placed under the flawed category, and this year also again India is under this flawed one. So here you can see that not much change in India. The rank, although has improved, last year it was 42, this year it is 41, but still our category is the flawed democracy category, and the score is 7.2 2-3. So actually 167 nations are there which are actually ranked. So India's rank, you can see here, 41. Top 5 democracies are also here. The Norway has actually the score of 9.87 out of 10. Then Iceland 9.58. So these are the 5 topmost countries. New Zealand is also here. And also I've mentioned about the bottom 5 countries. So you can see Syria, North Korea, obviously, then Congo. So these are the last 5 countries. So that would be enough for you if you keep in mind about the top 5, last 5, and even the rank of India. That would be enough for you. Do keep in mind that this Democracy India, the Democracy Index is actually by The Economist, which is a newspaper which is based in London. Okay, so this is again important, a very important campaign which has been launched by the Ministry of Women and Child Development. This campaign is Web Wonder Women. So the campaign is aimed at discovering and celebrating the achievements of women who have led the positive agenda of social change. But this social agenda has been driven through social media. So this is very important, keep this in mind. So now they have actually invited the nominations from the Indian women who are based across anywhere in the world. So you just have to be of the Indian origin, and you've worked some you have some exceptional achievements with you through social media. So you are eligible to be nominated here. So do keep this in mind. This hashtag #WWWWebWonderWomen is important. Although now only invitations have been announced. When it comes out, the awards are listed, then we'll cover it in detail. Okay. For now, just keep in mind about this Ministry of Women and Child Development, because earlier there was also this campaign called as hashtag MeToo campaign. So this hashtag WWW, you should not get confused that which one is related to the celebration of the women achievement. Okay, so your next news is about the first India Central Asia dialogue. So this is the first time that a dialogue between the India and all the Central Asian nations are going to take place, and it is going to be held in Uzbekistan. So it is expected to, or rather it has taken place now in January 12 and 13. It was expected to take place. So obviously it would be attended by our External Affairs Minister. Actually, it was co-chaired by our External Affairs Minister and the Foreign Minister of Uzbekistan, the host. So this would be easy for you that India is going for the first time. The host is Uzbekistan. So the foreign ministers of both the countries are actually co-hosting this. So let me tell you about the Central Asian nations. See, I've included a map here so that it becomes easy for you to know. And then also keep in mind that what are the actually the this Central Asian nations. See, Kazakhstan is here, then it is Kyrgyzstan, Tajikistan. So Afghanistan is also here. It is although missed in the map, it has to be here. Then Uzbekistan, Turkmenistan. So these are the nations, and all of them together would be coming in this dialogue with India. So this is very important. Again, a very important step by Indian government to strengthen its relations. Okay, another very important report, Global Economics Prospect Report. So first of all, you have to know that this report is released by World Bank. This you have to keep in mind. And now we'll move on to the findings of this report. So recently released report, it is about the global economic growth. This report has actually laid out a gloomy outlook for the global economy. And the report says that probably in the coming years, there could be again a global slowdown. So the global economic growth is projected at 2.9%. But what is important for India is that this report says that India is going to be the fastest growing emerging market economy with the growth of 7.3% in the fiscal year of 2019. So this is very important. You can compare here that the global economy is growing at the pace of 2.9%, whereas Indian economy at the pace of 7.3%. So and this is important, and let me just recall you that there was another important finding by ADB, Asian Development Bank, and they had also reported that Indian economy is going to grow at the 7.3 to 7.5% level. So this is important, do keep this in mind. And about this economic prospect report itself, the World Bank is itself a very important organization. Okay. So Supreme Court has set up a panel to suggest the reforms for holding the competitive exams. Now this panel is important. Let me tell you the background. You must know that there was a lot of controversy about the leaking of the SSC examination of 2017. So in the background of that, Supreme Court had this PIL, and they have now favored the setting up of a high powered committee which would actually lay the guidelines for the conducting of the competitive examinations by all the government bodies, including the SSC. So this committee is going to comprise Nandan Nilekani. This personality is important. We have discussed in our previous videos also. Are you able to recall any other committee related to Nandan Nilekani? If yes, please mention below. It is important for you. So apart from Nandan Nilekani, computer scientist Vijay P. Bhatkar is also going to be in this three-member committee. So till now we have only two names. We are going to keep this in mind, and also keep in mind that this committee is actually related to this question paper leaking and the guidelines for the competitive examinations. That would be it for you now. Okay, so this is about Ayushman Bharat scheme. So this we have discussed about this scheme, but this news is about the exiting of West Bengal from this scheme. So Mamata Banerjee has announced that she is going to exit this Ayushman Bharat scheme, which is also called as the Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. So this is important, and do keep in mind about West Bengal particularly. And let us cover now this recall Ayushman Bharat scheme. See, this is considered to be the largest health protection scheme in the world, which is going to provide rupees 5 lakh coverage to the 10 crore poor families. So it was expected that it is going to cover around 50 crore people in India. And here, see, actually states are supposed to be the 40% of the project cost, and the center has to be the remaining 60%. But according to Mamata Banerjee, the reason cited for her to exit this program is that the center is taking all the benefits, and it is showing this one, the PMJAY, as a central scheme only. So that is why, that is the reason given by her in the official letter. So anyhow, important for us is the exit of West Bengal and Ayushman Bharat scheme. Okay, so this is about Renukaji multi-purpose dam project. So this dam project is important because six states have come together and signed an agreement. So for us, these six states are important: UP, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, Delhi, Rajasthan and Uttarakhand. So they have come together, and this multi-purpose project is going to cater to the drinking needs and other irrigation needs of all the concerned states. And this particular dam project is going to be situated in the Sirmaur district of Himachal Pradesh. So these are two important things you have to keep in mind. Apart from that, important thing is that this multi-purpose dam project is going to be on the river Giri. So river Giri is actually the tributary of Yamuna river itself. So Giri and Yamuna, you have to keep in mind, and it is going to cater to the needs of all the states, especially Delhi. So you have to know that Delhi is actually dependent on the nearby states, especially Haryana and Punjab. So here, this multi-purpose dam project is going to provide relief to Delhi for its drinking as well as the irrigation purposes. Okay, moving forward. Sanskriti Kumbh. So this is again important. This Kumbh has actually begun at Prayagraj. So it is very important for us to know about this Kumbh itself, because especially it is now going on. So over a course of 12 years, this Kumbh is celebrated four times. That means after a gap of 4 years, and it alternatively takes place at the four places. So these four places we are going to see. First one is Haridwar, and River Ganga is there. Then Ujjain on the banks of River Shipra, Nasik on Godavari, Prayagraj. Now this present one is going on, 2019 one is going on in Prayagraj. So the river Ganga, Yamuna and the mythical Saraswati river have the confluence there. That is why it is called as Prayagraj. So this particular 2019 Sanskriti Kumbh is going on there. So a very important thing I've mentioned about Kumbh Mela, which makes this news very important. the UNESCO has actually inscribed Kumbh Mela on its list of the intangible cultural heritage for humanity. So Kumbh Mela is on this list along with yoga. So this is important for you. Do keep in mind about these four places and the related rivers also. Okay, so your last news is about the partnership summit. So this partnership summit 25th edition is taking place in Mumbai. Now it is being organized by DIPP and State Government of Maharashtra and a Confederation of Indian Industry. So CII, Government of Maharashtra, and DIPP, these three have organized this partnership summit. So this is actually a kind of platform for the dialogue about the globe, for the economic policy related to the global leaders coming together with India. So along with this news, are you able to recall there was this states ranking which was released by DIPP? If you are able to recall the state which had topped that ranking, of the state startup ranking which was released by DIPP, very important for you guys. Please mention below. If you're not able to recall it, go back, see that video again, or just find it out and then mention below. Okay, so you have to now tell me about the state startup ranking which was released by DIPP. You have to tell the state which has topped that ranking. Okay, so apart from this partnership summit, you have to keep in mind about in Mumbai that it is taking place here, the organizing agencies. And another important news which I have put here only in this particular slide is about the launch of the first Sino-Indian Digital Collaboration Plaza. So SIDCOP it is being called as. It has been launched recently and it would be a kind of boundaryless marketplace for the Chinese enterprises in India, so that they can come over here and provide business solutions and investment also. So keep this in mind, that what is the SIDCOP, and yes, that would be it. Okay, so after covering your so many important news, now we'll try to discuss the MCQs. I would recommend that you pause the video for a 10 second, try to recall and then answer the question. Okay, so let's start then. Okay, so question one is easy. Khelo India Youth Games 2019 have been organized in which of the following places? So this is the places. Is it Pune, Nagpur, New Delhi, Amritsar, or Indore? So our answer would be Pune. This is the second edition. First edition has taken place in New Delhi. Okay, so question two is, which of the following states has recently got India's longest single lane cable suspension bridge? So this again is easy. We have just covered it. Try to recall the answer. So our answer is option C. India's rank in the Democracy Index of 2018 is... So this is you, this is not that easy to remember. You have to just cram it up. So our answer is option B, 41. Okay, so Kumbh Mela is not organized in which of the following places? So this is a typical question, the four places I was mentioning. So now you have to identify which place the Kumbh Mela does not take place. You can pause the video, try to recall the answer. So our answer is Bhopal. So all the above given four places are where this Kumbh is actually organized alternatively after every 4 years. So final question is, Renukaji multipurpose dam project is situated in which of the following states? See, these are the participating states, that is, they have this agreement signed. Punjab is not there. The rest four are in this agreement for this multipurpose dam project, but it is situated in Himachal Pradesh state, the district Sirmaur. So here are your correct answers. You can just tally your score and let us know about your score. Let us know, how do you like this video? So yes guys, that would be it. If you guys have any query, you can just drop us a mail at hello@edutab.co.in. You can also call us or WhatsApp us at this number 8146207241. I would recommend you to visit our website so that you can get the information about all the courses, www.edutab.co.in. So yes, that would be it, guys. If you like the video, if you find the content useful, please do not forget to click like, subscribing to our channel and sharing this video. So that would be it from today's lecture, guys. We wish you all a very happy learning from the team EduTap. Thank you for being here.